evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another edition of the John Lebang Show. I'm your host, John Lebang, on this World War III-filled news evening. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
North Korea releases video of missile attack on America? North Korea has poached Michael Jackson's peace anthem, We Are the World, to soundtrack a chilling video showing a U.S. city under missile attack. The bizarre footage uploaded on the secretive state official website comes as Kim Jong-un prepares for an imminent nuclear weapon test. The propaganda movie depicts a smiling lad dreaming of a regime rocket being launched into the air and traveling to America. The 3.5-minute video then shows a mystery city full of skyscrapers being attacked with multiple explosions while the Stars and Stripes flag flutters in the background. Captions on the screen are written in Korean and say,
"Somewhere in the United States, black clouds of smoke are billowing."
North Korea is preparing to carry out two nuclear tests, either simultaneously or in rapid succession, to demonstrate to the world the advances it has made in its weapons program, according to intelligence reports. Analysis of the recent satellite images have shown new activity on the southern edge of the Pyongyang nuclear test site, while preparations at a second tunnel to the west were apparently completed earlier, a South Korean government source told the Chosun Ilbo newspaper. There is a widespread belief that North Korea will go ahead with its third nuclear test in recent history. With the regime still angrily denouncing criticism by the United Nations Security Council for the launch in December of what Pyongyang claims was a rocket to put a satellite into orbit. The South Korean military and international intelligence agency have prepared for the North's anticipated nuclear test and hope that data they can retrieve will provide new pointers on just how far Pyongyang has advanced in its efforts to develop a nuclear warhead that is small enough to be attached to a ballistic missile. Then we have Japan accusing China of using weapon radar on ships. Japan's defense minister, Itsunori Onoderi, accused China naval vessels of using the weapons radar in two incidents last month. On January 19th and the 30th, he said it happened in the East China Sea, suggesting it was near disputed islands controlled by Japan, but also claimed by China. He did not give an exact location. Onoderi said the action could have led to a dangerous situation. Shots were not fired on either occasion.
"It is extremely dangerous to use such a fire-controlled radar or radar for weapons firing,"
he told reporters in an emergency briefing.
"The incident could have led to a dangerous situation. We are sternly calling on the Chinese side to refrain from such dangerous actions,"
he said. The United States, which is a treaty ally of Japan, voiced concern. The State Department spokeswoman, Victoria Nuland, said such actions could escalate tensions and increase the risk of an incident or miscalculation that would undermine peace, stability, and economic growth in the region. "Falkland Islands will be under our control within 20 years, says Argentina. We just spoke about them yesterday. They told the IMF, you know, the international motherfuckers, to go to hell, that they're leading Europe down a bad path. Yep, the IMF, the international motherfuckers, that's what they're called here. judge, jury, and executioner. Legal experts fear implications of White House drone memo. Legal experts expressed grave reservations Tuesday about an Obama administration memo concluding that the United States can order the killing of American citizens believed to be affiliated with Al-Qaeda, with one saying the White House was acting as a
judge, jury, and executioner.
The experts said that the memo, first obtained by CBS News, threatened constitutional rights and dangerously expanded the definition of national self-defense and of what constitutes an imminent attack.
Anyone should be concerned with the president and his lawyers making up their own interpretation of the law or their own rules,
said Mary Ellen O'Connell, a law professor at the University of Notre Dame and an authority on international law and the use of force.
This is a very, very dangerous thing that the president has done,
she added. Attorney Eric Holder, in a talk at Northwestern University Law School in March, endorsed the constitutionality of targeted killings of Americans provided that the government determines such an individual poses an imminent threat of violent attack. But the memo obtained by NBC News refers to a broader definition of imminence and specifically says the government is not required to have clear evidence that a specific attack on U.S. persons and interests will take place in the imminent future.
So if somebody's going to be a problem down the line, well, you know, ladies and gentlemen, in 10 years from now, 15 years from now, that guy over there on the radio, you know, he might be an imminent danger, or he might be a danger. So we're going to have to take him out with a drone.
Virginia City bans drones. Now, isn't that cool? The use of drones for surveillance is not allowed in Charlottesville. The resolution supports a 2-year ban on drone use and prohibits the city entities from purchasing them. Another report offers a couple more details. City Council also passed 2 other resolutions, one banning drones, the other dealing with towing standards.
Just in case the drone, you know, like comes and flies and it breaks down, we gotta tow it away, yeah.
The anti-drone resolution passed by a 3-2 margin. And then the guy up there at the White House, you know, the press secretary, Carney, there, he goes, drone strikes legal, ethical, and wise. Are we getting it, ladies and gentlemen? Are you guys listening to what's going on? They are now saying it's okay to blow somebody up if they're an American, if we just don't like them, if we think they're a threat to us. Well, a threat to, let's say, a current regime is not always a threat to the country. A regime, a political party that is in power could target its opposition. Just saying, it's happened before. Go look at Germany. White House press secretary said Tuesday the administration's use of drones is legal, ethical, and wise. NBC News reported late Monday on an unclassified Department of Justice white paper on the use of drones against American citizens. Just type in Google, Justice Department memo reveals legal case for drone strikes on Americans. You'll find out everything you need on that subject.
This is the second song on our record.
I could give you a lifetime of reasons, but that would be too much. It comes down to one simple feeling that I can't say end up. It's not just the way you've become my salvation, your will to forgive every wrong turn I've taken, the strength that you give me when my world is shaken. You show me what I'm living for.
I love the way you love. I love the way you love. I love the way you love. You always seem to dance when I stumble. Never let me fall. You bring me back to life when I crumble. But the best thing of all is the taste of your kiss in a moment of passion. How you know what I need without ever asking. When I take all I can, but you keep on. And you show me what I'm living for. I love the way you love. I love the way you love. I love the way you love. So I give you my heart. I give you my word. I'll be with you above.
All right, and on the phone with us is our buddy Stoned Logic, who is out there in Colorado enjoying his legalized marijuana. Tell me, Stoney, are you calling about the move by Congress to change federal pot laws?
Yeah, man, hey, you know, man, thanks for having me on, by the way, man. It's really cool, man. I get to be on the radio. And, you know, you're kind of supporting the marijuana movement, man, and that's really cool, man. So, anyways, man, there was an effort in, is building in Congress, man, to change marijuana laws, including moves to legalize the industrial production of hemp, man, and establish a pretty hefty federal pot tax, but that's okay, man. You know, because then if I can just go buy my pot, man, anywhere I want, I don't have to worry about it, man. I'll just, you know, pay the government a little bit of tax. Maybe that'll help me get out of the deficit.
So, well, tell me more about it. Is it the Republicans or is it the Democrats doing this?
Well, man, you know, the passage this year could be a long shot, man. But lawmakers from both parties, man, have been quietly working on several bills. Yeah, man, you know, like the first of which, man, is a Democratic representative, Earl, I think his name's Blumenauer or something, man. He's from Oregon, man. And Gerald Polis of Colorado, man. Right here in Colorado, man. We love that guy, Gerald, man. They plan to introduce Tuesday, man, this bill, man, you know, to Congress, man. It'd be, to the House of Representatives,
so,
man. It's pretty cool.
What's the bill going to say, Stoney?
Well, man, the measure would regulate marijuana the way the federal government handles alcohol, man. You know, in states that legalized pot growers could have to obtain a federal permit, man. You know, oversight of marijuana could be removed from the, like, Drug Enforcement Administration, man, and given to the newly renamed Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Marijuana, and Firearms, man. And it may, you know, remain... Hang on, man.
Stoney, what are you doing, man?
Hey, man, just hang on, man. Just a second, man. You know, just hang on. So, okay, man, it was my turn, man. So, like, you know, like, marijuana, what were we talking about, man?
Man, we were talking about a federal agency just changed their name.
Yeah, man, they're called, you know, the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Marijuana, and Firearms, man. And it would remain illegal to bring marijuana from state where it is illegal, but, you know, that's okay, man, because, you know, we can smoke marijuana here in Colorado, man, and you can come out and hang out with us here, man.
What I'm reading here, Stoney, is that the bill is based on the legalization measure previously pushed by former Representative Barney Frank of Massachusetts and Ron Paul of Texas. Is that correct?
Yeah, man. So, like, you know, Baumgartner's bill would create a federal marijuana excise tax, man, of 50% on the first sale of marijuana, man, typically from a grower to, you know, to a processor or a retailer, man. It also would be like a tax, man, on producers and, like, importers, man, like $1,000 annual tax, man, and like on other marijuana businesses, man, like $500. But, man, you know, but, you know, that's a lot of money, man, that the government could have to pay off their deficit, man, you know. Because they're, you know, that way they don't have to, like, you know, tax my income, man.
Where does it go from here, Stoney?
Well, man, his office said Monday, man, that it doesn't have an estimate of how much the taxes might bring in, but the policy paper Baumgartner and Paulus are releasing this week suggests, based on the admittedly vague estimates, of course, man, that the federal tax of $50 per ounce could raise $20 billion a year, man. Man, that's pretty cool, man. They call for, like, directing the money to law enforcement and substance abuse treatment and the national debt, man.
So does this have anything to do with last year's vote on in Colorado and Washington State to legalize recreational use? Should Congress end this? I think it was like 75 years federal pot prohibition.
Yeah, man. Well, like Washington, man, the state, you know, them. Hey, man, hold on a minute, man. You know, just wait. Hey, man. Oh, man, you know. Man, like the state of Washington officials, man, have estimated that it is legal marijuana market could bring in about $500 million, man, in state taxes alone, man. So, like, you know, us folks here, you folks in Washington, man, you should come out and hang out with the friends in, like, Colorado, man. You know, because, you know, we're you know, because that'd be cool, man, you know. Well,
aren't we, like, still arresting 2/3 of a million people for the use of substance that most of us feel would be legal, like marijuana and stuff, right? Don't you think it's past time for us to step up and try to sort out this stuff?
Well, that's what I'm saying, man. Haven't you been listening, man? Man, I'm an advocate, man, you know. And we're working with lawmakers, man. And it could take a year or two or three, man, to get the changes through Congress, man. But they're encouraged by recent developments, man. You know, the Senate majority... Hang on, man. Yeah, man, you know, there's some good shit here in Colorado, man. The Senate Majority Leader, man, Mitch McConnell. Or Minority Leader, man, I forgot, man. You know, you're Minority, Majority, I don't care, man. You know, last week anyways, man, Mitch McConnell came out in support of efforts, man, to legalize hemp for his home state of Kentucky, man. You know, that'd be cool, man. You know, Kentucky's cool, man. And, you know, you gotta, you know, that'd be all right to legalize pot there, man.
So, Stoney, well, thanks for calling, man, and we'll talk to you soon.
Well, thanks a lot for letting me on, man, because, you know, we got to get this marijuana legal, man, you know. So, all right, man, talk to you later.
7 million will lose insurance under Obama health law. Overall, the new health provisions are expected to cost the government $1.165 trillion over the next decade. During the healthcare debate, Mr. Obama had said individuals would be able to keep their plans. But now it looks like they're not going to be able to keep their plans, or some people aren't. Then there's a new book out called What to Expect When No One is Expecting. It's definitely a progressive way at looking at a utopian world of a child-free America. Despite the gloom and doom predictions that never come to pass, overpopulation alarmists continue to make their case that society must restrict the procreation of human beings. In 1968, Paul Elwright's book, Population Bomb, said that hundreds of millions of people would perish as a result of an overpopulated Earth. Don't worry about it. The New World Order is just having constant wars. That'll keep the population down. Consumers taking financial hit from rising fuel prices. We spoke about this yesterday. With pump prices at their highest level on record for this time of year, the stage is set for an even greater climb in gasoline prices and expenditures than in 2012. Retail gasoline prices have surged 17 cents in a week to top $3.50 a gallon on average, posting the highest prices on record for the beginning of February. But everything's great with Obama in office. It's great. It's awesome. The U.S. military launches training program for Mexico forces. Will it backfire? Like the Fast and Furious program? And here's a reason to kill your neighbor. Angry Dallas neighbor allegedly kills two over dog poop. Residents at the Sable Ridge condominium complex say they'll never forget the sound. Michael Essa says that the 8 shotguns that rang out Monday morning scared him.
I just know I heard a whole bunch of gunshots at 8 a.m. I dove over my son to protect him.
Neighbor Yolanda Washington said,
I heard 3 gunshots, then it stopped, and I was about to rise up on the floor, and I heard 5 more, and I got back on the floor.
Dallas police say the suspect shot and killed 2 residents. Neighbors say both bodies laid outside. Ugh. While police haven't identified the victims yet, neighbors say they include a Dallas man and his girlfriend, who's a mother of 5 young children, ranging from 10 years old in age to a baby born just after Christmas. Police believe the shooting was a result of an ongoing dispute between the couple and their accused shooter, an elderly man who lived downstairs from them. That's a crappy old man. You know, the old man that yell at you when you cross their garden. Hey, get off my lawn, you little motherfucker! Neighbors say the feud had been going on for nearly a year and centered around a pit bull that lived in the couple's unit.
From what I hear now, they had a lot of arguments over the pet dog urinating on that balcony. But as far as I know personally, I never heard them argue or fight.
Resident Gilbert Lee says,
It's very sad. I heard the gunshots this morning. When I saw and heard it was her, how do you take this? She was here one day and gone the very next day. It's very sad.
Neighbors say the problem was the dog went to the bathroom on the balcony, which often dripped downstairs onto the suspect's balcony. That's what you get for living in an apartment with a pit bull and you don't take the damn dog out. You piss off the old man downstairs.
I'm gonna still kill you, dumb old murderer. I'm gonna go out there.
We've just gone crazy as a country. We have just gone crazy. Then we go over to Acapulco. A group of tourists have been raped by a masked gang who raided their holiday villa in the Mexican resort of Acapulco. Local authorities said the armed men burst into the bungalow rented by 13 Spanish tourists, 6 women and 7 men in Playa Bonfal, facing the Pacific Ocean near the famous Punta de Mante area, local authorities said. The attackers gagged and tied up the men with phone cables, then raped the women who had been bound up with their own bikinis. Police received an emergency call at 7 a.m., 5 hours after the tourist ordeal had started. A number of credit cards and tablets and 7,800 pesos were also stolen from the tourists, who are reportedly all under 30 years of age. The Acapulco state of Guillermo is experiencing a bloody turf war between drug gangs, the Michoacan family, and the Knights Templar.
So, the Illuminati is now down in Mexico.
Wow, the Knights Templar's down there. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, asteroid 2012 DA14, Earth flyby reality check. Small near-Earth asteroid 2012 DA14 will pass very close to the Earth on February 15th, so close that it will pass inside the ring of geosynchronous weather and communications satellites. NASA's Near Earth Object Program Office can accurately predict the asteroid's path with the observation obtained, and it is therefore known that there is no chance that the asteroid might be on a collision course with Earth. Nonetheless, the flyby will provide a unique opportunity for researchers to study the Near Earth object close up. So maybe it'll take out a satellite or two and we won't have internet for a day or so. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, this is John Lebang, the host of the most, with the most, and drinking a toast to all of you out there listening in. I thank you very much for giving me your time. And I'm signing out.
Oh, wow, yeah.